everyone. I'm so excited to bring you this practice, which includes some of my favorite restorative yoga poses for grounding and soothing your system and your energy and feeling both rejuvenated as well as relaxed. So for today's practice, you'll notice that I've got a chair close to me. I'm gonna invite you to get some kind of chair or something that is a little bit more up and a little bit higher than our typical, like if we use blocks, right, as a setup. So you want something like a desk chair or a kitchen chair. And if you don't have that, you could even use something like a little table or a little bar stool and just bring a little height to it. So you're gonna wanna have that, as well as a couple of cushions and pillows. So I've got a couple of pillows here that are about the same size as each other. You can use blankets as well, really. Anything could work as long as it's about the same size and that you've got two of them. In addition to that, I'm sitting on a bolster and a blanket. So I invite you, if you have a bolster, to get a bolster, and if you don't, a couch cushion is a great substitute, or another pillow, and then a blanket or another pillow. So about four cushions total and a chair. If possible, two of the cushions, same height. Now I just put some calming oils on my hands and my feet just to signal to my nervous system that it's time to settle and ground. If you've been working or doing something that's put you in a busy frenetic state before this moment, or if you just want that reset that is so beautiful in practice, I invite you to do anything that you want to help bring that in for yourself. You can spritz your face, take a drink of water, put some oil on, light a candle, do whatever feels nourishing for you. And then of course, for our last pose, we're gonna do three restorative yoga poses. For the last pose, it's really lovely to have an eye pillow or a scarf or something to cover your eyes and layers. So once you've got all those things, go ahead and find a comfortable seat where you're sitting underneath something with a little height underneath of your sit bones. Bring your hands to rest on the legs, and then you'll close or soften your eyes. And take a few nice breaths in. Breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. Gently close the lips and begin to breathe in and out through the nose. Let your arms relax. Attune to how you are in this moment, what your energy level is, how the body feels, any emotional tone, the quality and state of your mind. Feel into the wisdom of your breath, the truth of your experience of how you feel right now, whether you feel calm and grounded or a little bit of a mess. This practice is here for you. The practice of yoga provides that steady container to remember the truth of who we are, to give our tired bodies and overworked minds a break. Feel the wisdom of the heart and the clarity that comes when we pay attention to the body. In the season of winter, I find that the practice of paying attention to how we actually are can be challenging, because so often we're depleted and exhausted. the end of the year and the busyness of the holidays, the deep feeling of tired from the shorter days and longer nights, just remember that this practice is a solace, a safe place to really invite everything present, where we begin to, almost as though we're kind of stirring everything in a pot, we begin to really churn in how we feel. We can begin to process how we feel, any pain and grief in the body, the mind, and the heart. Anything that feels like it's bubbling to the surface, can begin to recognize it and notice it. Recognizing that in the same place where grief exists, life also begins. So feel connected to the earth wherever you are. Feel your grounding down through your sit bones, down through the soles of your feet, all the way deep into the center of the earth. The medicine of winter is the medicine of rest and slowing. The more we invite and welcome in that medicine in our busy lives, the more we'll become transformed and we'll actually remember what it is we truly want and need. So the medicine of the seasons helps us to awaken. Each season has a different piece of medicine, multiple pieces of medicine to help us remember who we are, what we're releasing, what we're mourning, what we're celebrating, what we're inviting in, and what's in the in-between. How we're changing. A great teacher of mine many years ago told me that either we're invited to open or close. And every moment in our lives is an invitation to open or close. Some moments are easier than others to open. But notice here, and closing is not necessarily withdrawing. Closing can be going inwards and churning. But notice how you feel right now. Are you opening or closing? And if you're not sure, just be curious. So we feel that connection to the earth feeding us, quite literally through the breath we breathe, through the ground we walk upon, through the food we eat, the beauty around us. Feel a connection to your body, down from your feet, your legs, all the way up through the pelvis, the belly, the back, the chest, through the arms, finally through the crown of the head. Feel an extension all the way up to the sky above, to the stars and to the moon. That remembrance of expansiveness and greater belonging and the mystery that holds us all. And draw your awareness back into your heart center and take three breaths from the heart. Feel the breath expanding from the heart. Drawing in, expanding, and drawing in. A couple more just like that. So feeling your breath expanding and drawing. continue that awareness, and we're going to inhale, circle our arms around us. Palms touch and draw the hands to the heart, to the chest. Couple more. One last time. Bring your hands to rest on the legs, arms relax, and softly begin to flicker the eyes open. We're going to come to all fours. Before we start the restorative practice, we'll just do a few nice stretches to help you open the body, especially if you've been doing a lot of sitting or standing. So from here, I'm going to scooch my chair forward a little bit so I've got a little bit more room. Begin actually with hip circles. Bring your hands forward a little bit. Tuck the toes. Draw your knees about an inch wider on either side and begin to move your hips in nice big old circles here. About five or so on each side. When you're ready, go ahead and reverse. Just feeling into all the nuance. The slower you go, the more you can feel. One more circle around. Come back to center, hands under shoulders, knees under hips. You can untuck those toes now. Cow and cat, slowly feel the belly relax, chest open. Just gaze to the front of your mat. Give your hips a little wag, a little sway. And come to center, feel that mid upper back draw up towards the sky. Let your head drop and give your head a little shake. Just move back and forth in cow and cat. And take just a few more. You can be swaying as you do it or not, that's up to you. The next time you're in cat pose, you'll just come back to a neutral table. Now from here, you're going to draw your right hip kind of in, like you're trying to cock your right hip towards your right shoulder and gaze to your right shoulder. Just a little stretch. And come back to center. Now cock your left hip towards your left shoulder and gaze towards your hip. Good, back to center. Now right hip toward right shoulder. Good, center, one more time, left hip, left shoulder. Good. Now we'll come to child's pose. So let your arms relax, palms face up, forehead down to the ground, or to a pillow if the ground isn't comfortable. Bring your palms to touch. Walk your elbows in a little closer so your fingers point up to the sky. We'll do about three more breaths. And bring your hands down and inhale, come up. Set up for our first restorative pose. So we're going to do a few forward folds, as I mentioned. You're going to want to have your chair or your prop on your mat or somewhat close. And we're going to want all of our props for the first shape that we're going to set up into. So you'll take a whatever is the tallest thing that you've got. So that for me is my bolster. I'm going to bring it somewhat close here to my chair, a couple of inches away. Then next, I'm going to take my pillow or blanket, whatever you've got, on top of the chair, depending upon your body. You may or may not need that, but just have it there in case. Now, I have pretty tight hamstrings, so I'm going to demonstrate the variation of this pose with support under your knees for the hamstrings. Also, this is the variation where if you don't necessarily feel like you need this under the knees, you can always just sit on your cushion. So set it up though, like I am first, where you bring these pillows that are about the same size, one on one side, one on the other. And you might need to adjust, you know, where your cushions are. But basically what we're going to do, depending upon your body proportions, you're going to sit on your bolster or nice pillow and bring your legs out into a V shape. And you'll notice that I'm adjusting my cushions closer in. I'm actually going to sit almost at the edge of my prop. If you have a sensitive low back that bothers you in this pose, you might need more height underneath of your sit bones. If you feel your back rounding or your shoulders kind of rounding, you might need that extra height. And I've got my blanket here on top of my chair. I'm going to bring one arm on top of the other. And then from here, you'll gently just lean forward a bit and bring your forehead to your hands. That feels like it's too much height. You can always lower it and come down. But just notice any changes in how it feels comfort-wise when you do that. Some of us who are maybe more flexible might be inclined to lower and not use as many props, but this is actually not about flexibility. This is about comfort and feeling like you can fully relax. And me, I can be flexible in certain ways, and my body could physically do the pose without the extra, but it's actually more of a stretch and more uncomfortable and not as relaxing. So begin to make any fine adjustments. And we'll be in each pose for a couple of minutes. So you want to be not at your edge. On a scale of 1 to 10 in terms of sensation and, let's say, effort, we want it to be really in like the 2 to 3, 4 at most range. So not very much effort. If this proves to be too challenging completely, you can always skip this section and go to the next pose instead if needed. And it might take you a few minutes to settle. So invite your body to surrender into the prop. We're going to begin to do a mindful counting. You'll inhale for 3. Begin to exhale for 6 through the nose. We'll do that for a few minutes. Oh, very slow. And with each number on the exhale, you're just relaxing a little bit more each number, each exhale. To open mouth, exhale at any point, that is okay. There are no rules. you're struggling at all on the exhale, remember you can always just pause and relax the body until you hit that number six. If you run out of breath, relaxing any grip that you notice, the hips, shoulders, jaw. Very slowly inhale, begin to lift the head up, begin to flicker the eyes open, and there's a little like almost shock sometimes from being in that fold. So you're going to move very slowly, and we're going to transition to our next pose. You'll bend your knees. You're going to keep your props in the exact same shape and just come to butterfly pose. If you have a sensitive low back in this pose and you notice it, like I kind of noticed that, you can sit on something. Switch your props forward if needed, if you need to make that little adjustment. And you can get a little bit more height underneath of you if that feels like the right choice for you today. Adjust so that way these pillows are underneath your knees. And then you'll lean forward and again rest. Bring your other arm on top just to switch that out. If that's uncomfortable, you can always bring one side of the face down instead too. We won't be into this in this variation for too much longer. We won't be in it as long as the first one. So about 2 minutes per side. Make any adjustments. Here, I want you to begin to soften the inner thighs, the hip flexors, and the pelvic floor as much as you can, just feeling a softness really from the hips down. Begin to breathe now in a 1-to-1 breathing ratio. So we'll inhale for a count of 4 and exhale for a count of 4. This pose in terms of effort might be more like a 5-6 on that scale of 1 to 10. If you've got one side of the face down, but invite you to lift that and then bring the other side down. Continuing with that breath count, four inhale and four exhale. Let go of the counting and just come to the breath that feels most supportive in and out for one more minute. Very slowly come back to center and again gently lift up. Final rest. Hopefully you're feeling calmer and grounded. Just stay in that space. Lean back, knees draw up. If you've got something on your chair, just move it to the ground. We'll scooch off of that high prop. Also move it to the ground. If you're feeling cold, make sure you grab your layers, maybe some socks. And you'll bring one of your pillows or your blanket back behind you. And I'm going to show you how to do this really lovely neck support. So it's very simple. You'll just take your blanket that's in like a fold like this. And from, do you notice how I have one side that's like folded a little bit longer? I'm just going to roll it. If you see, I'm just rolling it a teensy bit. So it's not that thick at all, right? It's not like all the way up or anything. It's maybe like a fourth of the way rolled. Okay, this is just for the natural curve of your neck. You're gonna bring this down with that roll facing in, the open side facing out. And you can adjust as you need. Now if you wanna drape yourself with any blankets or layers, I'm actually gonna grab my socks, put my socks on. I know my feet get a little cold. And the most mindful way to set up, so we're going to bring our legs up on the chair, and do note if you're on your cycle right now, for those of you who have a monthly cycle, the chair might be a little too high. So if you're on your cycle instead, you can take a pillow or two under your knees, so it's just like this on the ground. So it's a little elevation, you still get the benefits, but it's not as high. Or you could have your bolster under your knees or a rolled up blanket. But if you're using the chair, as a reminder, we come to our hip and our forearm, and we have our little blanket roll about an inch away from our elbow. Come to your shoulder and gently swing your legs up. Instantly feels so nice. Adjust so that way this nice, gentle roll is supporting the natural curve of your neck, and it will feel very, very gentle, not too dramatic. And adjust your legs however you want. I kind of let my legs open a teensy bit, but still supported by the chair. You can bring your hands to rest on the body or by your sides. We'll end our practice here. We'll take these last few minutes
in this nourishing, restful pose. Let go of any sort of breath control, like what we've been doing with breathing in a certain count or in a certain way. And for this last pose, just let your breath tell you how it wants to be breathed. Might take a few moments to adjust to that, but just let your body breathe how it wants to breathe. And invite your legs to grow heavy, your hips to relax, arms grow heavy, forehead and temples relax, share a reading here that I shared in my live classes this past week. And this reading in particular talks about the winter solstice and the potency of this period of time where we have our long nights and our short days and the magic that exists within them. Really all of our stories and rituals of this time of the year come from the magic of rest and the magic of spaciousness. This is why we're so tired. Nature is beckoning us into that place. And the more we're in opposition from that, the more we feel depleted. Entitled simply Winter Solstice by Mayana Welty. The night breathes slow, deep, long. The breath of the earth moves up to meet the stars. Slow down, dear one. Slow down, breathe. Dark has its own music. The dark has its own spell. The dark is the breath that unclenches, bringing sweetness to our deeps. Be as the sleeping mountains. In the rhythm of your patience, the world will be revealed. And the drumbeat of our hearts, all the lessons of the year, will tell their stories. Winter is stillness. It is deep calm. It is huge. Carry your candle, yes, but do not let it blind you to the radiance of the dark. Do not let it crowd out the silence. Do not let it deafen the music of heartbeat, breath, starlight, humanity. We turn the wheel of the year. We are time unfolding, seasons following seasons flowing through us, bodies, hearts, minds. We walk through the grace of the year and our wholeness is revealed. We walk through the wisdom of the seasons and learn ever more how to love what we love. Breathe in that wisdom for these last few sacred moments here. your whole body soften just a little bit more, growing a little heavier. Feel yourself held completely by the earth beneath you, by the props. Feel your breath nourishing you one more minute. Begin to just watch the breath and its natural flow in and out. Notice the effect in the body when you in-breath, inhale. And the effect when you exhale and take that out-breath. Keeping your awareness really relaxed, begin to take your thumbs and trace them across the tips of your fingers, going up and down all the fingers, staying relaxed but awake. You can move your toes a little, and draw your knees in and slowly rock all the way to one side. And press down through your hands and find a very slow, mindful seat. If you open your eyes to get there, go ahead and close them once you arrive. Once you're seated, palms face up and pointer finger and thumb touch, just acknowledging the effects, noticing them. The palpable effects from this slow practice, as well as the effects below the surface. May we remember to practice and live our lives in a way that serves the highest and deepest good, harm to none. Bring your hands together and bow your head down, remembering that this yoga practice is just different ways to tap into that reservoir, that wellspring that exists inside of you. May we all know ease, joy, justice, and peace. May we all awaken to truth. May we all be free of suffering, harm, and pain in this lifetime. May we all know freedom and liberation itself. Chin and open your eyes. Thank you all so very much. Wishing you a great holiday, however, whatever you celebrate, a blessed new year. Let me know if you have any questions. Wishing you all more rest, more hibernation, more laziness, and take care. Next up, you'll be receiving a meditation from me, and I'm so grateful to be in community with all of you, even through our videos. Still in touch. Much love. Stay tuned for new announcements in the year new in the new year for new offerings coming to all of you here too as well.